Hey friends, it's Sam from DIY Huntress, and today I'm going to show you how I built this custom live edge bench with welded legs to match the custom table that I built my parents. Let's get started.
This project is sponsored by my friends at the Home Depot. If you've been watching my channel, you'll know that I built my parents a custom dining room table this summer, and I'm super proud of the build, but the one thing that they requested that I didn't get a chance to make was a custom bench to go along with the table. Now, I built my parents' dining room table using two slabs of this gorgeous ash wood, and we actually picked up a third slab as well with the intention of using it for a bench. So in order to start this project, I just grabbed that slab out of storage and decided to rough cut it down to a size that was more manageable to work with. At this point, it didn't really matter how nice the cut looked or if it was a perfect measurement. Like I said, I just really wanted to get it down to a size to where I could fit the slab into my workshop and start working on it. Okay, so pre-warning time, if you watch my dining room table build, a lot of this video is going to look really familiar because the process is super similar. But basically, like I did in the dining room table build, the first step to preparing the slab for use was that I did have to fill all of the voids with epoxy, so I taped up any voids that went all the way through the slab and then began by tinting epoxy to the same color as the one as the table, which was like a really pretty brown, and then pouring that into the voids and spreading it evenly. I did have to do this process a couple of times because some of the voids were really deep. So in total, the entire epoxy process took about 3 days in total. Okay, now one thing I struggled with when I was building the dining room table was that I did not have proper equipment to cut the steel that I wanted to use to weld the base of the table. But for this video, I really wanted to prove that this is something that you can do even if you only have mostly woodworking tools. So I actually got my hands on a steel demon blade from Diablo as part of the prospective program, and I decided to put it to the test on some of the steel that I use for the legs of the table and the bench. And you guys, dead serious, I was so skeptical, but this thing cut through the steel like a total champ.
I cannot believe that just worked.
What?
Well, I guess you can cut steel at home when you're a woodworker.
Sick.
And because the square tubing that I used was the same gauge as the flat stock, it was able to cut through that as well, which was extra cool. Now, just like in the table video, the next step in this process was to start welding the pieces, and I had to prep all of the steel by grinding down some of the material and cleaning the steel up, and then I attached them using some right angle clamps, checked for square like 1,000 and a trillion times, and then began to weld all of the joints together. One thing I do want to dive a little more into in this video that I didn't get a chance to do with the dining room table build is that building a steel base and welding it is totally optional. I know that this is not feasible for everybody, but it is something that I wanted to challenge myself to do on this build. That being said, if welding a base is not an option for you, totally cool. I actually have linked a list of some pre-made metal bases that you can use for a live edge project of your own, and you can find that on my blog along with my materials list, my tools list, and all of that other fun stuff by clicking on the link below this video. But back to business, because my welds were not perfect, I did use a grinder as well as a flap disc to just smooth everything out and make it look really nice. And then I moved over to prepping all of the flat stock by drilling some openings into it to insert some threaded screws into later. And as you can see, in order to do this, I did just use a typical drill press that I would use for my woodworking projects. But if you don't have a drill press, you could also use a regular drill for this and just use the same exact step-up bit that I'm using here, which is basically just rated for metal. Another thing that I made sure to do was to keep some lubricant around, and this helped to prevent the drill bit or the metal from getting too hot. But once I was done prepping the flat stock, it was then time to weld the base that I made before to the flat stock itself. And I first did this by just tacking the corners and then making sure that everything was perfectly straight. And once I was happy with the alignment, I then permanently welded the base to the flat stock. I then used my flap disc to make sure that everything was nice and smooth and polished before bringing them outside to prep them for their finish. And I did this by using a self-filling primer, which filled in any of the major imperfections. I then sanded that primer down really nice and smooth, and then used a black metal enamel paint to finish off the bases. As the bases dried, I final prepped the live edge piece of wood that I was working with, and I wanted to show that this could be done using a regular circular saw and a really good blade. So I did get my hands on a new Diablo blade that is meant for cutting thicker wood and harder metals, and it cut through this slab so beautifully. I just installed the blade, set up a straight edge to run the saw against, and I was able to make my final cuts on the slab. And once the slab was cut to its final size, I then brought it back into my shop and began to remove the bark using a chisel and a hammer. Spoiler alert, this took forever, and I ended up using a different method later on in the process, but in order to get the bulk of the bark off, this did work really well. I just had to be patient. I then moved on to using one of my more favorite tools in recent projects, my power hand planer, to remove the bulk of the resin from the top of the piece and then give it its final leveling. At this point, I was not happy with the way that the live edge looked, so I used my angle grinder to remove the rest of the material. It was a little more aggressive than I wanted it to be, but it did work really well. And once I was happy with the leveling and the way the bark looked, it was time to remove the rest of the tape from the slab and then give everything a final sanding. Something that I absolutely loved about this piece and what made it so unique to me were these little bitty beetle holes that were in the live edge, and I wanted to preserve those, so I just used a steel brush to do so. And after everything was sanded nice and smooth, I then began the finishing process using my favorite finishing oil on the piece, and I started with the bottom first so that I could attach the bases next. After the bases dried, I installed some plastic end caps on the bottom of the square tubing, and then it was time to install. Now, if you see that dark piece on the slab, that is a low spot in the piece, and I didn't want to flatten the piece all the way down to that low spot because it would have made the slab super thin. So instead, I was just really careful to install the bases on the leveled areas of the slab instead. And once I was happy with the placement, I marked where I wanted to drill my holes for my threaded inserts, and I did that using my drill. I then cleaned out those openings and installed the threaded inserts using a little bit of epoxy and the drill that I used to drill the holes. Keeping it real here, I recently got my hands on this intense mechanics set through the prospective program, and it does come with a ton of different accessories, and I ended up using a couple of these accessories to install these threaded inserts. Even better, the set did come with ratchets that require very little space to move, and that made installing the threaded rods really easy since I didn't have too much space to work with because the legs were so close to the openings that the threaded inserts were installed in. But if you want to learn more about this tool or any of the other tools I'm using in my project, as I mentioned earlier, you can always just check out the post that I have for this build on my website by clicking on the link below this video. But ultimately, once I was done installing the base to the bench using the threaded rods and the threaded inserts, I then flipped the bench over and began to finish it using the same exact finish that I used for the dining room table. Because the bench is going to be part of this dining room table set, it was really important that everything just looked cohesive. And then after giving it some time to dry, it was time to install it in the dining room along with its counterpart, the dining room table. I seriously cannot be happier with the way that this dining room set came together in its entirety, and since my family is really close, I'm so excited to see it used and reused for generations to come. And also, if you're like me and you were worried about this bench being able to hold the weight of full-grown adults, don't worry, we had a family party recently, and after seeing four of my family members share the bench all at once, I'm no longer worried. In fact, I'm mostly just filled with pride and with love. I wish I could invite all of you guys to sit around this dining room table and have dinner with me and my family, because seriously, without your support, a project like this would not have been possible. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you subscribe for more videos in the future, and until next time, friends, happy DIYing.